I could have sworn I seen something in the corner of my eye go across from left to right.
Well, the ghost searches are and have just arrived at Dobbins Inn in Carrickfergus. This is the first time we've been here as a new team. We've been here before a couple of times with quite a few interesting things that have happened. We're going to try to lead on to what happened on the last time we were here. We're going to do a bit of spiritual work to fire up the energy from the start. We're going to do a bit of seance. We're going to use a Frank's box. And then later on we're going to split up and do lone vigils. Anne has come up with a fantastic idea that we've never done before as a team. And we're going to see how that pans out later on.
Is your name Elizabeth? If it is, come to me. Were you... Did you murder your lover, Elizabeth?
Sorry.
I'm getting... I'm so dreadfully sorry.
Ask her, was it the 16th century?
Did this happen in the 16th century, Elizabeth?
Sophie just walked past that
window. Yeah, I see that.
The shape of a person. Just walked past that window.
Somebody switched the light off.
No, it wasn't. Those lights are automatic. They're on a timer.
They're sensors.
They're only going for so long.
Uh-huh.
Something actually walked past that. Not on the inside of this room. Past it.
I'm just seeing somebody standing, wringing out a cloth.
Ask her where she locked. She locked away in a room somewhere.
Were you locked away, Elizabeth, in a room? Come to me if you were.
No? I saw things the same way.
Could you point the glass to where she's standing?
Does she have a little boy?
Sorry.
Looks like she had any children, don't you know? She said she was barren.
Can you point the glass in the direction of which you're standing, please, Elizabeth? To let us know where you are, please. Thank you.
That's racing the shadow.
Did you go past the window, Elizabeth? Come to me if you did.
Ask her, can't you come towards the table?
Can you come closer towards the table, please? Thank you, Elizabeth.
Oh, whoa.
What's wrong?
Just got a light anomaly come straight onto the table.
I'm really cold.
No, that's quite unusual.
Maybe you don't want us here. If you don't want us here, move the table. Let us know for sure you don't want us here.
Here.
And we'll go.
A woman?
I heard. Yeah, I heard that.
Did you hear that?
I thought that was outside.
No, that was in here.
I'm sorry. I know somebody tugged the back of my treasure.
That's good.
You alright?
Yeah.
Scared the Jesus out of me.
Look at you.
Oh no, just smell you.
You should almost talk about nitrogen.
We want to speak to Hazel, do you understand?
That's
French.
What did you say? That was French.
French.
It is French. I don't believe that.
Oh, it is French.
It says it is French.
I heard that, yeah. You heard
that?
Yeah. Pardon for your long legs.
Oh, what is French?
I understand.
Qu'est-ce que c'est?
That was French, dude.
Oh, I've got the...
That was French.
I don't believe this. Ask him to speak French. Right.
Est-ce que vous comprenez français?
Now,
did I hear?
I heard very loud. I was about to say the very start. I heard it. Yeah, well, we were trying to do a seance upstairs, and I was actually walking around taking photographs, and I was sort of back towards the window with my body towards my face towards the door, and on my right hand side, I seen a shadow. Shadow was the shape of a person, shadow of a person moving from right to left as I was looking at it. Now, I wasn't the only person to see it. I think she had seen it as well at the exact same time. She got a yelp. What was that? All I can say is, from my knowledge of this building, because I'm very knowledgeable of this building, was that is where the door used to be. The door wasn't originally where it is now. It was actually where we had seen the shadow of the two of us. And later on, during the seance, a couple of the other team members actually seen the same thing. Only they took it out to be a small shed, was walking past. Now, what we have to bear in mind is, in that corridor outside where we were, if anyone had walked past, it would have triggered the light sensors. Which, you know, there was residents walking down again up past, and the lights came straight on. Well, as soon as the door was open, the light came straight on. But there was no lights come on. It's baffled me, actually. But the shadow was left there, and there was no light coming from the room. Because, you know, the only person in that room was me, and I actually stood still to take a photograph. I don't know. Well, we'll try it at one bit, but okay. As of yet, we've had no answer for it.
Mm-hmm.
When we were here before, we had EVPs, French, come through in French. Now, I know that in the 1700s, the French actually attacked and took his town over for a period of days. And there was a lot of French casualties within the town, between them and the English fighting. So tonight, on the Frank's box, we heard French coming through. And one of the girls speaks a bit of French, called out in French, and we got response in French. Baffled me, I mean. I don't know any French radio stations around here, or French taxi drivers, so we can put that out of the equation for a start anyway.
Okay, so far you'd say it's a good investigation.
Tonight has been remarkable, so it has, just like the first one, it's an amazing place.
Okay, alright then, let's see what the rest of the night holds for us as a team.
Oh yes, I mean, the night's only young, I mean, that's the start of it, so happy I'm sure days. We'll get plenty more.
Okay, cheers, thank you.
We're at the second part of the vigil tonight, we're downstairs in the function room, Dobbins in. Now, you were saying about you're going to have do an experiment.
What I have thought about tonight, why don't the four girls sit and try and do it another way? If you take one corner and I take another corner and the two girls are the same, and David sits in the middle and maybe asks questions and we can maybe do automatic writing.
That'd be good, yeah. So you're saying hopefully whenever David asks questions, if we show the answers there, if it all comes out that we all have the same answers,
well, you
it'd
see,
be amazing one.
Well, you see, the thing is, if he asks if there's a spirit in this room,
mm-hmm.
and what's her name,
mm-hmm.
and they write John,
mm-hmm.
well, if even two of us get that name, that's terrific.
That's very good, yeah, that's a brilliant
You know, what
idea,
do you think
yeah.
of that?
I think that'd be a great experiment.
What
I'll see it's doing
so, I'll conduct it first of all. I'll get you started anyway, all right, for yous. So none of yous can see basically what yous are drawing then. Okay, so we've got
Rachel.
We've got Nicola. We've got Nicola sitting around, obviously, around the middle of the room. Okay, so that's Nicola there. We've got Sheena,
mm-hmm.
over the other side of the balcony. Just stick your hand up, Sheena. Sure. Say hi, everyone.
Hi.
Hi. And then we've got Kaz at the far end of the room. Say hi, Karen.
Hi, Karen.
And then we've got the legendary Anne. Hello. Okay guys, so what we're going to do is, if we can get the heads down and try to get a quite a high concentration level going if you can. Okay, try to block everything out of your mind. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to say something. And it's the first thing that comes into your mind, okay? So what I'm going to say is, if there's any spirits in this building to come forward into this room, please do so. And try to show yourself to the four ladies in this room. Okay, girls, and what I would like you to do, if you get an image into your mind, to draw it down on the piece of paper. That's right, okay.
There's always
time to
the
center
table here. Center table?
Center table.
Put
them where you were sitting. I want to have the
inspiration. There's one, two, okay.
I might
see
both sides.
Where'd it start off this side?
It started off there.
Look at the hat.
Oh, good.
I
It's a big furry thing.
It's a busby. They call it a busby.
They're Russian hat. You know the Russian hats?
No, because I had one when I was normal. It's a busby. It's who's up when you look right here.
Yes.
So it is. Yes. It's a cavalry officer's hat. So it is. So I had one, and then you got a stream coming down off it. So that's what it is. But it's actually called a busby.
Well, that's what I said, it has the head instead of crossed over legs.
Yeah.
I just kept getting 1562.
What I got was a child. It was a child, it says it was a child. Occupation, stable hand. His name was Oliver and he was born in 1826.
I'm getting Grackhall, but I don't know if it's a name or whether it's a country or something.
Go.
Jail was the first thing that I got.
This used to be police station, Peeler Station. Peeler Station.
I got jail.
Or yeomanry, whatever it was. But I know it was, and people were held here. So it wasn't for a long period of time, but it was here.
Right.
And there has, believe it or not, been soldiers seen here. Old type soldiers, that's where you were.
His eye was very swollen. Really swollen hair, big cut down the face, and looks really dirty, very unkempt and dirty.
What was that?
Yeah, that was my feet.
Was it? Around.
I just kept getting L.
That's fine.
So were you picking up a nationality to this person?
Sorry, a personality.
Yeah.
Really worn out. Right. Really, really worn out. Been through the wars.
You say he's from a different country.
I don't think he's from, I don't know where he was, he didn't look from a different country, I just didn't recognise the
hat. You know what's fascinating about this? He's got a buzz
bean. He looks like he's been wounded.
You get in the window, Draco.
I don't know what that is.
You know what I'm thinking you're trying to write is Dragoon.
What does that mean, David?
A Dragoon is a cavalry soldier.
Sorry?
Yeah, a Dragoon's a cavalry soldier and that was a headdress with a worn. That's fascinating to me, that one. So it has, especially when soldiers have been seen here before.
Yeah.
A dragoon is the Royal Dragoon Guards, the Queen's Royal Dragoons, all of them. They're still about the 10.
Right.
And that's the ceremonial dress I have now, the busbies. That one's really impressed me. The jail too. And who's to say there wasn't a stable on him? I mean, this building's been here over 800 years.
We've just come out of the room here after doing a seance and I was talking away to Sheena and we seemed to have heard something around the corner. Now this, whatever we heard was actually louder than what we were talking. So basically I says to Sheena, don't know what I was saying, but what I thought I heard anyway, the best way I can describe it was like a shuffling of a dress, how crazy that may sound. So I looked at Sheena and she looked at me and I says to Sheena, did you hear that? She says yes. Sheena, what did you hear?
We both heard it exactly the same time because we both, and it was like a dress that couldn't fit down the corridor.
Uh-huh.
It was like it was rustling
against
the walls.
Yeah, so when we heard that then initially we both walked around the corner thinking there was somebody standing there. There was nobody in the corridor. It was completely empty. And the only two people in the corridor was ourselves. Where that noise came from, we have no idea. There's no radiators to make that noise resemble that noise. We went to the end of the corridor thinking there was somebody down at the far end of the corridor. There was nobody there. So where that noise came from.
And it continued.
It did. But where it came from, we've no idea. And to us, it's a complete mystery.
Ballygrand, I was. deepest ocean, the deepest ocean, for my love to find. But the sea is wide, and I cannot swim over, neither have I the wings to fly. If I could find me a handsome boatman to ferry me over to my love and death. Happy time spent so long ago, my childhood friends and my own relations have all passed on now like me.